Well, I wonder if this will actually work. How does it get any better? Take three, y'all. And now it's on the phone. I took it off Wi-Fi. We're just on, you know, connecting to the elementals and the phone network. So, I won't be able to read comments as well. Sorry, because the screen's like teeny and it wasn't working on my laptop. But anyway, here I am. Take three. So I've got this lovely book with me. It is my I Carry It With Me Everywhere I Fucking Go book, the Prosperity Consciousness book by Stephen and Chutisa Bowman. Fucking brilliant. Really, like, oh, just a delicious, delicious book. And I'm super grateful to Stephen and Chutisa. One, because they said, hey, go ahead, read this out loud. How much fun can you have? And two, because they've single-handedly, well, not single-handedly, because the two of them, plus Mr. Gary Douglas, have inspired me, really, to step into knowing that there's something totally different available with money, with prosperity. You know what? Beyond that, with choice, with being willing to step into being me and to receiving more, to contributing more, to enjoying life and living a hell of a lot more. So we are on to chapter two, darlings. Money is not the problem. The problem is our unwillingness to receive. Chutisa discusses the following areas in this chapter. Receiving, how much are you willing to receive? Receiving the greatness of who you truly are, the art of receiving everything without judgment, and tools to enhance your ability to receive money and everything else. It ain't just about the money, honey. It's just part of it. Money is actually really easy to attract. There's an abundance of money and resources, a never-ending supply. It's only unwillingness to receive that makes these things hard to obtain. We've learned from discussions that we've had with clients, with colleagues, and workshop participants from around the world that many people have wounds and negative beliefs around money. The wounds and the beliefs have different storylines, but their effects and consequences are always the same. They prevent money from flowing effortlessly into our lives. We've discovered that money is never the problem. The problem is your unwillingness to receive, which is a byproduct of the way you think about money or about yourself. And this chapter is one of my favorite chapters because this is exactly where I kept hitting my head against the wall. You know, that never changes anything, does it? Becoming willing to receive. Steve and I finally came to understand the source of our own and of most people's money problems during a conversation we had with Gary Douglas, the founder of Access Consciousness. Gary said something that helped us to understand our own state of affairs around money. You can see how highlighted this is. Receiving is the problem, and you, my darling, you are the solution. The issue is not the money. The problem is that you are not willing to receive you into your life. I'm going to repeat that. The problem is that you are not willing to receive you. You looking at me? That's it. I'm talking about you. The problem is you're not willing to receive you into your life. And the main thing you're unwilling to receive is the greatness of you. Unwillingness to receive the greatness of me is the problem? I was intrigued, and Gary suggested that I ask myself and the universe a question. So, universe, what's it gonna take for me to be able to receive the greatness of me? That's a damn good one to wake up with every day, huh? What's it gonna take for me to be able to receive the greatness of me? We were inspired by Gary's statement that we were willing to receive. What we were willing to receive determines the amount of money that we can have in our lives. He said it was essential to look at what we were unwilling to receive, because this determines the amount of money we're willing to have. We saw that the willingness to receive everything is essential if we are desire to create wealth, and it is also indispensable if we wish to keep the wealth. So Steve and I realized that we were the only ones who knew what was stopping us. We would only be able to get to the truth of the issue once we acknowledged that receiving is the problem and we are the solution. We ask ourselves a question. What am I unwilling to receive about me that if I were willing would allow me to have the totality of me? Then we began to look at what we were unwilling to receive in general. We discovered that we were blocking ourselves from receiving money in the same ways that we were blocking ourselves from receiving many other things in our lives and in our work. Receiving the greatness of you. Becoming aware of what we were unwilling to receive about ourselves was a new frontier for Steve and me. Gary said to us, "The main thing you are unwilling to receive is the greatness of you. If you're willing to receive the uniqueness and the greatness of you, and willing to allow the world and everyone to see the uniqueness and the greatness of you, the world will then gift to you what you truly desire." When I asked him, "Well, what would take for that to happen?" Gary answered, "Honey, you have to have a willingness to perceive and receive yourself differently. This is the beginning of creating what you truly desire in your life. That's the place where you have to begin." And as I thought about it, I got insight into how I was unwilling to receive the uniqueness and the greatness of me. Not only was I unwilling to receive my greatness, I was actually rejecting, negating, and denying my uniqueness. I didn't want to be different or stand out from the crowd. I was doing everything possible to hide my power. I assumed it was virtuous to be modest, humble, and understated. I thought that the only other alternative was to be obnoxious and full of myself. I'd misidentified and misapplied the notion of humility and modesty. I'd been taught during my early years to avoid being conceited, boastful, and self-serving. I was conditioned to turn away from self-acknowledgement and avoid talking about my achievements. I thought it was a good thing to be unassuming and modest about my talents and abilities. And after I talked with Gary, I began to ask myself this question. What am I unwilling to receive about the greatness of me? Okay, guys, write that one on a post-it note and stick it on your mirror as you brush your teeth in the morning or whatever. What am I unwilling to receive about the greatness of me? At first, I felt I was being kind of naughty, immodest, and self-centered. Gary and Steve pretty much told me to get over myself. This broke down the idea that I needed to conceal my power. My reaction was, "You mean it's not arrogant to receive the greatness of me? Could I really do that without appearing audacious and conceited?" I'd utterly bought into the lie that there would be negative consequences if I let myself be seen as confident or glorious and magnificent. I had suppressed my confidence and my potency because I thought it was improper, obnoxious, and conceited to be boastful. I had bought the lies and limitations as I was growing up, and then I tried to create my life based on them. I was constantly hiding my power and keeping my talents and gifts hidden from others and from myself. And I'm sure it was only Chutisa, right, with that? Or does that apply to quite a lot of us? Once I became aware of what I was unwilling to receive about myself, I was able to stop pretending that I was weak, pale, and uninteresting. I saw that for me to have something glorious and magnificent in my life, I had to develop a more conscious attitude towards my body and myself. I had to be willing to receive myself in totality without judgment. That's a key. I had to be willing to claim, own, and be everything that I am. I had to be as unconventional, weird, wacky, and outrageous as I truly am, no matter how uncomfortable that might be at first. I had to stop equivocating and choose me no matter what. The place where I had to start was the willingness to perceive and receive myself differently. I had to stop stifling and suppressing my talents and abilities. Suppression was the way that I used to manipulate and control myself. Freedom began with the willingness to receive the greatness of who I truly am. Not just to wishfully think about it, but to actually experience it. I had to truly live who I am right here, right now, instead of thinking about who I am as something outside of me. Something that I had to manage, or something that I would like to do someday in the future. When I started receiving the greatness of who I truly am, then everything in my life started to transform, including my financial situation. And since then, I've had an array of extraordinary experiences and have received money, which have further transformed my view of myself and of my potential. Has anything like this ever happened to you? How many times have you refused to receive the greatness of who you truly are because you thought it was improper or because you did not want to be ridiculed? How much more could you have if you were willing to receive the greatness of who you truly are? Acknowledge your unwillingness to receive the greatness of who you truly are and all of the talents and abilities and awareness that you previously decided that you couldn't have. Will you now claim, own, and acknowledge them and destroy and create anything and everything that doesn't allow them to exist? One word of warning though, if you choose to practice receiving the greatness of who you truly are, you have to be willing to be seen for who you really are. You have to be willing to receive anything from anybody. Even your great Aunt Trudy, yeah? You have to be willing to receive compliments, accolades, and admiration, as well as criticism, disapproval, and ridicule. You don't have to buy the responses as real. You just have to be willing to receive it all without judging you or others. What if we decided that we can't receive, whatever it is, it limits what we can have? Steve and I made the willingness to receive everything without judgment as the guiding principle in our lives. We practiced it our way. We practice it in our way of being with one another and in our board and leadership consulting business. If we're experiencing a limitation or a difficulty in our lives, whether it has to do with work, family relationships, with clients, business dealings, or even sex and our interactions with each other, we know that there has to be something that we're not willing to receive. One of the greatest insights that I've had using the Access tools is that in order to create any kind of limitation, I realize that I have to cut off my receiving. It is only what I have decided that I cannot receive that limits what I can have in my life. We've learned that if anything in our lives is not working, it's because we're unwilling to perceive, know, be, or receive something. When we notice that we feel limited, we make it a practice to become more receptive and vigilant. We catch ourselves in the act of resisting or reacting to something and ask ourselves this question, what am I unwilling to receive here? And in practicing this, we discovered that there was not any one particular point of view, theme, or subject that we were unwilling to receive. It was a myriad of things, lots and lots and lots of them. So asking ourselves, what am I unwilling to receive here, has allowed us to become more aware of our fixed points of view about reality and how wealth can be created. Being open and willing to receive everything with gratitude and without judgment has allowed us to expand our awareness and our ability to access infinite possibilities beyond our previous experience. We've been able to create a highly successful business as well as new seminars and products, which in turn have created expansion of consciousness for the business world, more clients, and more money for us. But more importantly, we've learned to navigate the world with ease, joy, and an exuberant expression of life. How does it get any better than this? What else is possible? Be willing to receive everything and to lose everything. Steve and I had noticed that when we were willing to receive everything and also willing to lose everything, then we expand our capacity to overcome the inevitable obstacles and see things through. The willingness to receive everything without judgment is an art. Its skilled practice takes a great deal of discipline, immense dedication, and powerful determination. We found that when we're willing to receive everything, we have the benefit of enjoying everything as it is. There's no need to alter or change anything. We advocate a lifelong exploration of the willingness to receive everything without judgment. This practice requires us to live with total awareness, and we discovered that in order to stick with this practice, we've had to do three things. One, develop the discipline to notice the times when we refuse to receive. Two, build the dedication to persevere until greater awareness becomes embedded. Three, discover within ourselves strong determination for a conscious way of being. We've had to step up and become more than we had been willing to be in the past. This has required the willingness to be more and more and more in every respect. We had to stop refusing to be who and what we truly are. We have had to be willing to put ourselves out there in a way that we were not willing to before. We've had to be willing to be controversial and to stir the pot. We've had to defy, defeat, and destroy those old erroneous definitions of ourselves, of each other, and of our business. And once we made a demand of ourselves to receive the greatness of us, then our business started to expand and thrive more than we could have imagined. We created more clients, more products, more services, more opportunities, and more income. And after we made the willingness to receive everything without judgment, the guiding philosophy of our lives, our levels of perception, clarity, and insight took gigantic leaps forward. The willingness to receive everything without judgment is the dynamic power that gives us the audacity, the confidence, the strength, and the courage to do what we want with our lives, to see things through, and to overcome the inevitable obstacles. Receiving everything, no matter what it looks like. Well, as soon as we chose to practice the willingness to receive everything, we became willing to be more unconventional and controversial in our work. We talked about notions, concepts, and practices that were not often heard about in boardrooms and senior executive teams. Our business started to expand exponentially because we were willing to be more. We were willing to do things that shifted other people's thinking. We were willing to receive everything, including judgment and criticism, no matter what it looked like. And soon, we became leaders and pace setters on that inspirational and leadership conference trail, and in great demand for internal workshops with boards and directors. Since Steve has become willing to put himself out there in a way that he was not willing to before, he's been invited to provide keynote presentations to conferences on topics that other speakers feel are too controversial. He now willingly speaks about subjects such as consciousness and corporate strategy setting and board governance. When he presents to large gatherings at conferences, there are often in excess of 600 people in the audience. Many of them are not able to receive his message about consciousness and awareness. Well, since Steve is able to maintain the space of receiving everything, even rejection and criticism, he never gets nervous. He is able to facilitate expansion of consciousness even for people who are not willing to receive him. He leaves his audiences inspired with practical conscious leadership tools and tips that they can apply at work, at home, and in their communities. Even if people were unable to accept the message, they still go away with interesting anecdotes and techniques. Something profound and transformational has happened to Steve as a keynote speaker. Since he has chosen to be willing to receive everything, he's developed greater insight and clarity of inner vision that he never had before. He has repeatedly been invited to facilitate workshops that assist senior executives and board members and leadership teams to become more conscious and to lead with awareness. And we're now willing to be daring and audacious. We speak out on contentious subjects, and because we're willing to receive everything without any judgment, business people from all over the world are showing up and inviting us to work with them. How does it get any better than that? What else is possible? What are you unwilling to receive? Time for some tamarindo. Yum, yummy. Look at what you're unwilling to receive. In truth, if anything in your life is not working, it's because there's something you are unwilling to receive. You may even discover that you're unwilling to receive money. When we coach people to shift out of their scarcity paradigm into prosperity consciousness, one thing we notice time after time is their ability to create unlimited amounts of money is conditioned by two factors: the points of view that they have about money and the willingness to receive it. We've discovered that the amount of money that a person has created in his or her life is in proportion to the willingness or the unwillingness to receive it. Said another way, people's willingness to receive money is conditioned by the points of view that they have about how much money can flow into their lives, actually into how money can flow into their lives. Our client's ability to receive and create money resides only in the points of view that they have bought as true. The common viewpoint many of our clients have about money is it's not good to have too much of it, and it's not a good thing to receive from others. Well, this viewpoint expresses an unwillingness to receive from anywhere. Very often, people's unwillingness to receive directs the course of their behavior and actions. And when they constantly focus on what it is that they constantly focus on, plays a key role in facilitating what, when, where, why, and how money can show up in their physical world. Practical processes. So what I love about this book is that there's all sorts of little goodies. You get little gray boxes and tools and questions and stuff. And in some cases, even, let me show you, because it's around here somewhere, there's little QR codes also for videos. So might be a really good idea to get your hands on a copy of this book and have fun with it. Practical processes. An important step in cultivating the willingness to receive everything without judgment is developing the willingness to claim and own the capacity to receive. Even though you may have no idea what that means or even what'll be coming to you. A key part of being willing to receive everything is to stop resisting and reacting to any situation you or anyone else has. When you catch yourself resisting and reacting, ask yourself the following questions. Okay, what am I unwilling to receive here? What ideas or viewpoints have I created that are stopping me from receiving? Now, these ideas and viewpoints may seem meaningful, significant, or even sacred to you. It may be challenging for you to actually look at them. Then what would it be like to receive from everybody without judgment? What would it be like to receive from everybody without any point of view? Having a point of view can be a judgment and largely automatic and unconscious. So more on judgment. The thing that most limited my capacity to receive was judgment. I noticed that whenever I went into judgment about anything, whether it was a positive judgment or negative judgment, I stopped myself from receiving anything that didn't match that judgment. I stopped myself from receiving anything at all. Whether it was a positive or a negative judgment, I stopped myself from receiving anything that didn't match it. I discovered that every judgment I had about what money meant to me created parameters around what I could receive. The most limited and absurd judgment I had about money was that it was taboo to talk about money. I used to see money as part of something I didn't understand. I was brought up to believe that discussing money was offensive and in bad taste. I bought an erroneous point of view that money was a personal subject that shouldn't be discussed and certainly shouldn't be taught or talked about in public. I used to feel embarrassed, frustrated, and uncomfortable when I had to talk about wealth or money. From the moment I chose the path of conscious prosperity, I knew that when I resisted thinking or talking about money, and I was declaring to the universe my unwillingness to receive it. So here's the bottom line. When I avoided talking about money or even thinking about it, I was creating barriers to receiving it. Nobody else has done that, hey? Oops. Sorry, phone fell. That was funny. Phone is still falling. That is super funny. All right. There we go. I may not be able to make it through the end of the chapter. Hold on. Actually, yes, I will. Ha! I have to go see my daughter on the gym floor. She's doing her routine. So here we go. Here's the bottom line. When I avoided talking about money or even thinking about it, I was creating barriers to receiving it. My reluctance and resistance were only a receiving issue. Not only that, but it took a huge amount of energy to keep my judgments about money in place. And until I was able to feel good about having money, and plenty of it, I would not be able to receive it. Let's see if I can actually put this here. There we go. That way we're not like directly at boob level. Sorry. All right, so once I recognized that, I asked myself two questions. What do I want? And what feels best? I realized that I had to choose to be greater than I had been willing to be. So I made a demand of myself. I chose to stop putting up barriers to receiving money and to claim and own my ability to talk about money with ease. And that decision started the process of becoming excited and wholehearted about seeing the value of me, my life, my work, and I chose to be elated about the way that our clients and potential clients could benefit from our services and our products. Next one for practical processes. Another little gray box. You are the only one who knows what is stopping you from receiving money. You can use the questions below to help you discover the points of view that are preventing you from receiving unlimited amounts of money. What am I absolutely unwilling to receive that if I were willing would manifest as total abundance? I'm going to ask that again. You can take your time and write it down if you like. What am I absolutely unwilling to receive that if I were willing would manifest as total abundance? What am I unwilling to receive that would allow more money into my life? What am I unwilling to receive that would allow more money into my life? What are the defining elements of my reality with money? What are the defining elements of my reality with money? And if I had a lot of money, what would I be that I'm currently unwilling to be? If I had a lot of money, what would I be that I'm currently unwilling to be? The willingness to do something, the willingness to do something is not the same as actually doing it. During money and consciousness workshops, Gary often asks people, are you willing to do whatever it takes to create a huge amount of money? And most people respond, well, yeah, yes, of course. However, when he asks them, so would you do prostitution for money? Then most people respond with firmness and conviction, no way. He chooses prostitution as an example, as most people have a lot of judgments attached to it. They often react to this question in an unconscious, judgmental manner. And this example shows that we often misidentify the willingness to do something with the actual doing of it. Now, when you say you would not do something, whatever it may be, it indicates that you have a judgment that it is wrong, bad, improper, or indecent. However, when you're willing to do something, you let go of all the points of view about it and truly choose. If the decision to not do prostitution is actually made from choice, then it's a conscious choice. If it's made from a fixed point of view and an unwillingness to receive all the judgment and everything else that might be associated with prostitution, then it is an unconscious choice. And this is an example to illustrate the difference between conscious choice, I'm willing to be a prostitute, but I choose not to, and an unconscious choice. No way, Jose, I would never do that. Practical process. Here are some questions that will help you to look at your decisions regarding what you're not willing to receive money for or what you're not willing to do for money. Please give this exercise a try, even though it may seem peculiar or out of the ordinary. You may discover some interesting decisions and judgments that you've made. 1. Is there anything that you would not be willing to do for money? So grab a piece of paper and like write that down. Is there anything that you would not be willing to do for money? What kind of work or activity can you not imagine yourself doing? And what projections, expectations, and judgments do you have that create the "I can't do that" mentality? Now, what if you'd be willing to let those go and look at them as just an interesting point of view, and then be able to step into actual choice rather than this fixed point of view of "I can't do that"? Become willing to receive everything. When we're willing to receive everything, then we release attachments to the emotions, events, or judgments that obstruct our awareness, so we have greater clarity about what is possible. When Steve and I did this exercise ourselves, we were amazed to discover many hidden decisions that we'd made about what we would or wouldn't do for money. And once we became aware of the decisions, well, we chose to destroy and uncreate them. Now, anytime we catch ourselves thinking or saying, "I would never do that for money," then we instantly destroy and uncreate that decision. Willingness to receive does not mean that you have to physically do everything that's been asked of you or presented to you. It does not mean you are obligated to do something or conform to anyone else's requirements. Willingness to receive everything simply means that you release attachments to the emotions, events, or judgments that obstruct your awareness, so that you can have greater clarity about what is possible. And at the end of every lovely chapter in this book, there is like a compendium of different tools that you can use. So I'm going to read them out loud. And like I said, might be a handy book for y'all to get. And maybe even get for some friends and family and gift them, because this book is just unbelievably wealthy, rich with tools, and just so amazing. I am so grateful, Stephen and Chutisa, if you see this, just know I adore this book and I'm so grateful to you guys. So tools you can use to enhance your ability to receive money and everything else. Receive the greatness of you. Some questions that you can ask. What's it going to take for me to receive the greatness of me? Ta-ta! What am I unwilling to receive about me that, if I were willing, would allow me to have the totality of me? And what am I unwilling to receive about the greatness of me? Wow, everything that is. Destroy and uncreate it all. Right, wrong, good, bad, all nine, pock, pock, shorts, boys and beyonds. Way to go, Eleanor, reading that with me. Awesome. Say to yourself, all of the unwillingness to receive the greatness of who I truly am, and all of those talents, abilities, and awarenesses that I decided I couldn't have, I now claim, own, and acknowledge, and I now destroy and uncreate anything and everything that doesn't allow them to exist. Right, wrong, good, bad, all nine, pod, pock, shorts, boys, and beyonds. Develop the unlimited capacity to receive. Questions to ask. What am I unwilling to receive here? What ideas or viewpoints have I created that are stopping me from receiving? What am I absolutely unwilling to receive that, if I were willing, would manifest as total abundance? What am I unwilling to receive that would allow more money to come into my life? And what are the defining elements of my reality with money? Receive everything without judgment. Questions to ask. What would it be like to receive from everybody without judgment? What would it be like to receive everything from everybody without any points of view? And if I had a lot of money, What would I be that I'm currently unwilling to be? Is there anything that I would not be willing to do for money? What kind of work or activity can I not imagine myself doing, like, at all? And what projections, expectations, and judgments do I have that create an I can't do it mentality? And what if you would be willing to look at those and actually see about letting them go? Might be interesting. Might just open up a thing or two. A space for new possibility anyway. So again, this has been my super well-worn, well-loved, amazing copy of Prosperity Consciousness by Stephen and Chutisa Bowman. This lovely couple right there. And this was chapter 2. I will continue tomorrow, maybe. Not sure if it'll be at this time, though, because today's Thursday, and I'm not going to be here for gymnastics in the afternoon, so it'll probably be in the morning. But I'm going to continue chapter day till I read the book. How does it get any better? It's lovely to have y'all with me, and thank you. And now I'm going to go off and see my daughter's gymnastics floor routine. Bye, y'all.